We're live. So, those are the three shows. This is Bayani Galera, and then Popcorn of San Penaso, and Pieces of Us is a two-man show of Raymond Guevara and Obscure Prototype Lab. So, this is, we're going to San Penaso's area. This is his installation art. He found a lot of saints, but he assured us that these were never used in churches, so it's safe to play around with them. So that's Sam's, and now we're going to Bayani Galera's area. He usually paints chairs, mid-century modern chairs, school chairs, different kinds of chairs, but this time he wanted to put it in the context of a home. So this is a huge painting. Installation of different chairs. Ang tahanan ay walang hugis o anyo. Ito'y pakiramdam na ikaw lang ang nakakaalam. This is his first solo show, and we're happy to launch it before the lockdown. He also collaborated with several artists. This is with Garapata. One painting corresponds with a chair.
That's Ron Welbahan.
And then Nico Pelaez. Fitz Herrera. Lynn Barrera. Where's his chair? I think it's back here. This is Lynn's chair. And then Weepo. His chair melted. So yeah, this was a fun collaboration. This is so witty. This is by Burai. And this is the last show. This is Raymond Guevara. His work is quite nostalgic. He collects different stuff from the 80s and 90s. And then he puts them together. Just some effect that we put in. And then, Wilmer, can you turn? Shows. At least the shows were able to run for a week before we had to close. Right now, like most galleries, we have gone online. So since we closed, at first we didn't know what to do. Maybe we waited around 2 weeks. We were inactive for a few weeks because we didn't know if it was right to continue selling art during a pandemic. So after 2 weeks, we put up a fundraising event, a fundraising art selling event. We tapped some of our artists because we also want to support them. And then it's called Art for Science. And the beneficiary is the UP Medical Foundation, which is a research institute. And the beneficiaries will be, the foundation will be providing PPEs to scientists and researchers and other health workers. So that will be ongoing for a couple of months. We'll just keep doing it until we exhaust whatever art we have. And then like most art galleries, we will be going online. That's the only way to survive. We will be mounting our first online show on the last week of June. We'll be releasing details soon. But we're practically an interior design firm. And we put up an art gallery kasi we wanted to show the people the relationship of art and space and how art can improve a space and how a space can talk to art and vice versa.
Yeah, because we believe that art has an important role in a space. It completes the story of a space. So, actually before the lockdown, we're already doing this. We have several interior design projects, homes and offices, that we do our interior design, and then we also collaborated with several artists that had shows here in Space Encounters Gallery. So until now, yun ang ginagawa namin for our gallery. So meron siyang interior design, and then the furniture and the art together. So in a way, those are the things that make us survive.
Because that's the important question paano nagsusurvive ang art gallery during this time? Number one is, yes, do selling online to make the payment scheme convenient for the client. So we weren't really geared for that, but we slowly worked towards it because kailangan na. And then also commission work.
Yeah.
We started accepting and actually even approaching clients, would you like a painting done for you? Because you just have to be more active nowadays. Art Plus had several questions for us, and again, thank you Art Plus for inviting us. We're quite a new gallery. We're 2 years old, so it was quite challenging when the pandemic happened because we were just building up our market and our regulars, and then this happened. But in a way, at least everyone's playing at least at the same field right now. So going online has made us adjust our marketing and our way of talking. It's important not to be tone deaf at this time. There's a lot of adjustments, but a lot of those adjustments are really how you communicate and what you communicate. Art Plus has a few questions for us. So what have we been doing? Art for Science, and we're readying our first online show on June. And it will, I think, include Mark Kills.
Yeah.
Humbly, it's a group show. And Chantariel.
Yes.
But we're still completing the list.
Because right now, the main concern kasi is when you have a gallery, you want the people to appreciate your art in physical form. Makikita mo siya. And that's the challenge. So the best thing that we can do is to create something that will make it still interesting, visually appealing. I think it will work pa rin because we know that example, they know the artist and they know their style, yung kanilang pagpahid ng pintura. So, I think in a way, kaya pa rin siya.
And then, we want to answer this question, this specific question, what is the role of art in a pandemic situation? Because I think historically, ang art talaga is nagiging historian. So, it documents what the people are going through in a particular time, and I think this is a especially trying time with many emotions coming out. So I think art, looking back, the art produced during this time will be very important. Hi, Yannix. Because because it will document everything that we are feeling right now. Our sense of disconnection, our rage, our fears, our sense of hope. So, actually, we are looking forward to what artists are producing right now because they are very emotional, very angry, very hopeful. You have coming from extreme emotion. So, art is still very important because it will be documenting practically our lives as a people. What do you think will be the impact of the pandemic in the art scene? I mean, we will be doing online shows for quite a while. I think maybe 4 months, maybe until the end of the year. Even if we become GCQ, we would still be doing online, most shows online. And then, if ever we do open, we're thinking of hindi na sa opening night, we'll be extending, like it's gonna be an opening week where people can visit the gallery for an entire week. Because we will be limiting the entry of visitors, parang siguro with our space, siguro max ng 5 visitors, and then after that, another 5, or if someone leaves, just to complete the 5. But practically, so no more opening nights, no more huge gatherings, they'll just be extended openings, which will last a week. But aside from that, I think yan na yung pinaka immediate solution for now when it comes to physical distancing in gallery openings when we do open to the public. But I think everything will be going online. And then it's helpful because online-wise naman, I think we can do just walkthroughs. At least the people can experience, you know, the show. A little bit slower than what I did earlier, obviously. Because as space encounters, as interior designers, we do like setting up, we like making stories, we like creating themes. So that's one thing that the pandemic won't allow us to do anymore. I mean, large scale. But we can do maybe intimate setups and just do virtual tours of the shows. And then, Art Plus specifically likes this question. How would you like to remember these times? I think what's scary is that it's not the silence or the empty streets, but how fast everything changed. Like, overnight, you're suddenly at home, and everything has changed. And I think that's how I'll always remember it. It's the time when we all change. This is life-changing. When we realize the flaws in the system, at the same time, we struggle to start again. So this is both, I think the pandemic is a time of reflection and fighting and thinking how to restart everything. So that's how I remember it, even though I think it will last for a few more months or years.
Ako naman personally, the first month is really, really hard. But it's the thing kasi na you receive many information, lahat, and you have no control dun sa mga bagay na yun. So, after that is, what I realized is the acceptance that it's really happening. And eventually parang, do the things that you have control because outside you have no control. Especially how long will this take, and also when will the vaccine be discovered. So it will be parang one day at a time. And that's like si Thor, sinabi niya na paano mo siya maalala. I think sa akin, something that is really marked a period where this is a self-reflection, I think.
And this is also the time, I think, when we realize how good we are at survival. And it really lies on how good we are at pivoting our direction so we can survive. So the Space and Colors Gallery is, you know, doing its best to survive. Our interior design firm is also doing its best to survive. We're actually trying to offer to commercial clients the new layout, when the new normal layout of restaurants. Commercial establishments are really taking it slow right now, so we're also doing interiors of homes. And I'd also like to show you our staff. Just one. These are the abandoned offices. But we'd like to thank everyone who joined us today. We'd like to thank all the artists who have supported us and the artists of this current show. Nasayang hindi matagal, kaya at least may exposure pa rin dito. So thank you everyone, and we hope you learned something, or at least we're able to entertain you with what the gallery has to offer. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night.
Bye-bye. Take care.